to go back to David Carr because he came out in 2002.
Yes, sir.
That's the year I was in Tampa Bay. And we didn't have a first-round draft choice. We had to trade a first and a second rounder for a star. That was me. We couldn't take your brother. I want to know what it's like witnessing a brother going number one in the draft.
Right.
What was that like?
Yeah, it was amazing. Again, that's something that not a lot of, 12-year-olds get to experience. Going to the draft, just witnessing those things, it's such a blessing.
But he's still a big part of your life, isn't he? I mean, he's at every one of your home games. He still looks like a movie star. But he comes to all your games. He was the man at Fresno. What's it like having a big brother that played at this university as your number one supporter?
What an advantage. Just what a blessing it is from God to have, a guy like that who's been through, the roller coasters of this game. I've been around, football, around the NFL game since I was 12, 11, 12 years old. I remember sitting down with him. He's getting ready for the Jacksonville Jaguars, just another Sunday, afternoon game. And I'm sitting there at 12 years old saying, oh, it's 3rd and 4. Okay, the nickel's pressed. Oh, they're playing 2-man this time. Oh, he's doing this. Oh, they're blitzing this time. 12-year-olds aren't supposed to watch NFL games and do those things.
I played quarterback. My brother played quarterback in Louisville.
Yep.
I played at Dayton. Are you better than them?
If you're both on the board,
both on the board, who are you taking?
Yeah, I'm taking me. Yeah, because I'm a competitor, and he'll say the same thing. He'll say, I'm taking myself because we are extremely confident in what we do.
Nah, you can't answer this politically correct.
No.
You're not like him at all.
No.
You're in a totally different offense in a totally different era. And your position playing style is totally different.
Yeah, it is.
Now, I want you.
Right.
What do you say about that?
I appreciate that. Let's go win some championships now.
70% completions, 113 touchdowns and 24 interceptions. This is a lot of yards, man.
Yes,
how many yards? 13,000?
Yeah.
Is your arm sore?
No, sir. I can throw all day.
Where's Derek Carr throwing the football with the great ones?
You can line anybody up against me, and I'm going to throw against them. And I like my chances, in the most humble way. There's not a throw that I can't make, and if I have to make it, I will make it. I'm very confident. I feel like I can fit one in behind a corner's face. I feel like even if the guy's covered, I can put the ball where it needs to be so we can have a successful play.
You're 6'3", 220 pounds, you run 4'6". You got a great pedigree with your brother.
Yes,
you call all the plays in college and you average 50 points a game. What's wrong with all the reading I've done? I don't see your name up here in these mock drafts. Is there something I'm missing?
No, sir.
Is there a flaw, a dramatic flaw?
No, sir. There's two different kinds of perceptions of me. There's one in the media, and then there's one that matters. There's the ones that I'm getting from the coaches, the GMs. That kind of perception is a lot different than the one you hear on TV. So we'll find out on draft day.